Hello, and welcome to this demo video for the VMware Tanzu Application Platform, where we'll explore how the platform can provide a superior developer and operator experience on any Kubernetes cluster on any cloud. My name is Ryan Baker, and I'm a technical marketing architect for the Tanzu Application Platform, specializing in the operator experience. Today, I'll play the role of an operator responsible for getting a newly developed application deployed while promoting my organization's DevSecOps culture.
And I'm Aaron Torgerson, also on the technical marketing team for Tanzu Application Platform. I've been focusing on the developer experience, and therefore today, I will play the role of software developer building a new application.
Thanks, Aaron. Before we jump into the demo, let's do a quick overview of what the Tanzu Application Platform is and the value that it provides to your organization. The VMware Tanzu Application Platform is a modular, application-aware platform that runs on any compliant public cloud or on-premise Kubernetes cluster. It delivers a superior developer experience with a pre-paved path to production, including all the needed components pre-configured for developer teams to build and deploy software quickly and securely. It is a composable platform so that teams can customize it based on their organization's preferences and changing business needs. With the Tanzu Application Platform, you can deliver revenue-generating applications to the market more quickly because your developers can spend more time building great software instead of toiling and stitching components together. You can realize economies of scale from your multi-cloud Kubernetes platform that lets you unlock developer productivity, build rapid yet sustainable paths to production, and coordinate the work of dev and ops. Throughout our demo, we'll touch on how the platform facilitates each of these, and how developers and operators, using the roles defined for each by the Tanzu Application Platform, can quickly build and deploy a Spring-based application named Spring Sensors, which is a web-based application that gathers temperature data from remote sensors. We'll explore the Tanzu Application Platform's inner loop, where developers build and iterate on the application, and the outer loop, which provides the pre-paved path to production defined by operators. To get us started, I'll hand it over to Aaron to talk about his role as a developer using the Tanzu Application Platform.
Thanks, Ryan. As mentioned, Tanzu Application Platform is built to span the entire software development lifecycle. It is a composable platform to enable plugging in different tools to reach the desired state of the deployed application. The inner loop is simply the software developer's environment for doing their work. As a developer, I mainly need three things available in my inner loop. Number one, a good starting point. Number two, good tooling to use while coding and testing. And number three, an easy path to a production-like environment. How will Tanzu Application Platform help me out? For a good starting point, I usually have two options. Number one, I can clone an existing Git repository, or I just have to find something and start it myself. With Tanzu Application Platform, you can use Application Accelerator to actually help you start your project. As you see on the screen here, this is our Application Accelerator menu or view, and it basically has a library of applications or starting points to applications to start a project. Since I'm going to be working on building a new sensor application, I want to find something here that will be suitable. So I will try to look for the Spring Sensors application here, and we can find it real quick. There it is. So we'll choose it. And this will open up a form for us to fill out to do any customizations to the code before it is downloaded. These are all different options based on which accelerator you choose. So we'll just leave the normal ones here and then go to the next step. The next step will be just to create the tarball or zip file. And so the zip file gets created, and then we'll just simply download it and we'll be ready to start our project. Now that we have our starting code, the second thing I need is good tooling. The IDE is where I want to do all of my coding, testing, and debugging. Since this application will ultimately be running on Kubernetes, I also need a way to easily run it that way. Fortunately, with the live update feature of Tanzu Application Platform, I am now able to stay in my IDE even when my code is running on Kubernetes. Let's see how it works. First, let's check localhost, make sure nothing is currently running. We're good to go. So let's go back to our IDE. And to start this live update, all we need to do is right-click on a tilt file that's part of the accelerator, and let's start the application Tanzu live update. Now what this is going to do is actually use the supply chain to actually build an image for me based on the source code, push it to a registry, and then actually deploy it and run it on Kubernetes, and I'll be able to look at what's happening live. All right, so the process will start. You can see the log messages will start to scroll here for the build and the other things that the supply chain is doing. So we'll wait a few minutes for the application to restart with its changes a couple times, and then we'll go check our browser to see if we have a running application. All right, it looks like our application is coming up. It's receiving the data. We can tell by one of those messages there that says it's receiving data. So let's go check out our browser. We go to localhost 8080, and we'll see our running application. The Tanzu sensor database application up and running. So now as a developer, I actually want to see some live changes. As we can see, our error message here, not our error message, but our log message here is pretty bland. So I want to add something to that log message and then see that change running live within my Kubernetes. So we'll go to my code and simply do a cut and paste here for the log message. We get our change the log message here to add a little bit more data to get the ID. And then basically all I have to do after that is save it, and Tonzu Application Platform will put those changes into our running container. So let's save it and see what happens. So I saved it. You can see the log message is changing, and this is Tonzu Application Platform taking over and pushing those changes to my running container. We'll wait a few minutes to see our new log message come up. All right, so we can see ID here, but there's no data, so I made a mistake. So let's go back to our log message and make a change to actually see the data this time. We'll add the correct information and save it again. And once it is rebuilt, we'll now see our ID information in the log message. So we have made a couple changes here and did two rebuilds of our container, and it is now running on our Kubernetes cluster. Now that I've done my work, I need that easy path to production. The awesome thing with Tanzu Application Platform is I don't need to do anything special. The same supply chain I use to build and deploy my code live is the same as the path to production. Usually, this would require a wall of YAML and config files to build my images and deploy them to Kubernetes. Luckily, we can do everything we need with the one simple YAML file you see on the screen here. It's called the workload.yaml file. This is the only thing needed. As you can see, you tell it what Git repo to watch. You see the section about services claims. That's how I was actually able to use my Rabbit database automatically during my live reload. The same file will be used to deploy it to production. One thing you may have noticed during this demo is I didn't show a single Kubernetes command. That's the beauty of Tanzu Application Platform. To get a glimpse of what gets created on my cluster, here is a listing of my default namespace to see what was created for us. At this point, I'm ready to check in my code and send it to production. Let's hand it off to Ryan and see what happens next.
Thanks, Aaron. Now that the code has been committed to our repository and is ready for deployment to become a live application, we can switch our focus to the outer loop. As mentioned previously, the Tanzu application platform clearly delineates between the roles of developers and operators, but promotes a graceful handoff between the two teams rather than a throw-it-over-the-wall mentality. Before we dive into the details of how the Tanzu application platform deploys our application code, let's review how it promotes a successful handoff between Aaron and myself. If you recall, Aaron performed all of his iterating and debugging of the code by deploying the code to a real Kubernetes cluster using the live deploy and live debug functionality of the Tanzu Application Platform's IDE plugin. This allowed the application to be developed in an environment that will closely mimic the environment it will ultimately be deployed in. In addition, the development process uses a consistent image build by using the Tanzu build service as well as consistent conventions to ensure that both the container image and the Kubernetes configuration is consistent between development and production. When combining these three features, the Tanzu application platform greatly promotes consistency between development and production environments and reduces much of the toil caused by environmental differences. Now that we've discussed the handoff, let's deep dive on the outer loop. Typically occurring post-merge of code, the outer loop provides a pre-approved path to production that can be defined by your organization's process. This path frequently includes any number of steps such as testing and vulnerability scanning. These paths of production are defined in the Tonzu application platform as supply chains, and for this application, we'll demonstrate an out-of-the-box supply chain, which for a given source code location will test the code, scan the code for vulnerabilities, build and sign a container image, scan the resulting image for vulnerabilities, and finally, apply standardized configurations and deploy the applications to a Kubernetes cluster. Now that we've reviewed the steps of the out-of-box testing and supply chain, let's take a look at how this works by deploying the Spring Sensors application, which Aaron just completed developing. We'll start by creating our workload via the Tonzu CLI. The workload.yaml, which was included from the Application Accelerator scaffolding, provides the Tonzu application platform with the information required to deploy our application. Once we submit this, Choreography takes over to step through the supply chain we outlined previously. In order to watch Cartographer step through the supply chain, let's watch the pods that are being launched and examine each step. As mentioned, the first step in our supply chain is to perform our integration tests, and you can see that the testing pod has automatically started. Since the Spring Sensors application was built using Maven, we are simply performing a Maven test to run our suite of tests defined for the application. This can take a moment, so let's skip ahead. As you can see, there were no failures in our tests. Now that testing is completed, let's see how the supply chain puts the security in DevSecOps. As you can see, the next pod that has been launched is a scan pod, which is using the gripe image scanner to scan the application source code for any vulnerabilities. The result of the scan will be compared against our defined scan policy to determine if the deployment can continue. Before looking at the results, let's take a look at that policy. Note that our policy defines that any critical or high severity vulnerabilities will violate our policy and cause our deployment to fail. Now, let's take a look at the results. We can see in these results that the scan completed successfully and no CVEs were found on the source code. These results are also uploaded to the Tonzu application platform's metadata store for archiving. We'll take a look at those a bit later. After the scan phase, a build pod is kicked off. The next step of our supply chain is to build the image using the Tonzu build service, which uses cloud-native build packs to build OCI-compliant container images using years of best practices and optimizations and security from the open source community. These build packs analyze the source code to determine if they are applicable, and if so, are executed against the source code to build the required layer images, which removes the need for your operations and development teams to build and maintain Docker files, which streamlines the build process. As mentioned, this is the same process that was used to build Aaron's development image, which promotes consistency between development and production. Again, this process can take some time, so let's fast forward to the end. The image has now been uploaded to our container registry. Additionally, the Tonzu build service has signed the container image, providing validation that the image came from a trusted source. This can further be taken advantage of by enabling image verification in the Tonzu application platform, which can prevent any untrusted images from running in the cluster. Now that we have signed the image, the next step in our supply chain is to scan the resulting image for vulnerabilities, again using the gripe scanner. Let's take a look at those results. The results show that a scan was completed successfully, resulting in the discovery of 27 CVEs of both medium and low criticality. Since this passes our security policy of no critical or high severity vulnerabilities, this deployment will be allowed to continue. Before we move on, let's take a look at the results of the scan that were uploaded to the Tonzu application platform's metadata store. Let's explore these. We'll supply the digest SHA of the image that was created, which allows us to view all the packages that were found in the image and what vulnerability exists for each package. Conversely, if we wanted to search for any images that had a specific vulnerability, we could do that as well. This would allow your organization's operations team to quickly find any applications which have been deployed on the Tonzu application platform with a specific vulnerability. The final step in our supply chain is to use pre-approved conventions for the workload type and deploy the application to your Kubernetes cluster. These conventions prevent your development and operation teams from having to build and maintain the quote-unquote wall of YAML that's typically associated with getting an application running in Kubernetes. Let's take a look at the Tonzu application platform GUI to see our deployed Spring Sensors application. From here, we have a wealth of information about the application at our fingertips, including the team who owns the application, where to find the source code, and any supporting tech docs. If you drill into the workload, we can see all the metadata available for the workload, as well as the routes and revisions of the deployed application. By following the URL, we can see that our application has been successfully deployed to our production cluster and is gathering information from our sensors. To review, Aaron began our demo in the inner loop by creating a new application from an accelerator, then used the developer tools provided by the Tonzu application platform to iterate and debug on the new Spring Sensors application. Once he completed development, we shifted to the outer loop, and I was then able to deploy the application with an out-of-box supply chain, which quickly took us from source code to URL while testing the code, building and signing a container image, and scanning for vulnerabilities, all with little to no involvement from our development and operations teams. If you'd like to learn more about using the Tonzu application platform, please visit tonzu.vmware.com and stay tuned for more videos as we explore more in-depth topics such as advanced developer experiences, vulnerability remediation, image signing, exploring conventions, and more.